Australian values or clear off. That's the message to Islamic schools in Australia from the Federal Education Minister. Something else that gives the World War One story of Simpson and his donkey as an example of the values to me.
It's about an unarmed man with a donkey who over some 40 days rescued a number of injured and wounded men. He was unarmed with a donkey, and he represents everything that's at the heart of what it means to be an Australian.
The medium is the message. The medium is the massage.
Or you may come in strength. You may even come in the uniform of our own troops. We must not allow him to gain entrance to this base.
The medium is the message. The medium is the massage.
Anyone or anything that approaches within 200 yards of the perimeter is to be fired upon.
It was literally the other side of the world.
Well, most people aren't aware of it. Anyone who travelled through the area was under surveillance.
Do you think that offered enough opportunity for public consultation, for debate about it?
Well, there would have been virtually no public consultation or debate. At the time, the southern hemisphere, the Monte Bellos were about as remote a place as you could find.
Was easily accessible to its navy, yet out of the international eye. And not only did the Australians consent, but went out of their way to help. Determined to develop her own bomb, and spent £100 million to that end. This was to be the test. The bomb was rigged in the hold of an old frigate, the HMS Plym, anchored in a lagoon off Tringawell Island. And on the morning of October the 4th, 1952, they counted her down. According to scientists, the blast generated a heat flash of 1,000,000 degrees. It hoisted tons of mud and seawater 10,000 feet in the air. The Plym disintegrated, and thousands of radioactive metal fragments showered down on the islands for miles around.
Of course, what we were viewing was, as awesome as watching a volcano explode or seeing an earthquake. And what we saw was certainly awesome in itself. This sudden flash and this huge pillar of smoke, and the knowledge that here was a cloud at its base about a mile across, and that would be an area of total destruction.
Since the federal government reopened the islands in 1967, the only people to live permanently on the Montebellos are these two men. For more than 9 months, Chris and Noel have manned a radio outpost on the island where two of the atomic blasts were centred. Their equipment beams signals to ships surveying a route for a natural gas underwater pipeline.
Of course, you're aware of the history of the islands.
Since the federal government reopened the islands in 1967, the only people to live permanently on the Montebellos are these two men. For more than 9 months, Chris and Noel have manned a radio outpost on the island where two of the atomic blasts were centred. Their equipment beams signals to ships surveying a route for a natural gas underwater pipeline.
Of course, you're aware of the history of the islands.
Yes and no. Just recently we've been reading about the radioactivity in the place. We know about the blast, but we didn't know there was any radioactivity here now.
How far do you think ground zero is from this island? It's only a few hundred yards, wouldn't it?
I should imagine it, yeah, probably a few hundred yards, could be a bit further down. But I don't know what sort of effect it has on you or has on us or anything.
Well, how often do you find material around the island, evidence that there were tests conducted here?
Oh, stacks of it all the time. Yeah, he was pulling me over.
just reading there's so many times that it's not advisable to pick up metal. We used to get the flaps of our tent stand with bits of metal and stuff like that, so.
Welcome back. Killing the Cranes, the name comes from a story you tell of meeting with an Afghan friend of those large white birds that usually fly over the sky in Kabul, and he looks up and he realizes not there, and he says, have we even killed the cranes?
Sadly, yes. It was basically symbolic, meaning that when in end of March the cranes used to fly over Kabul, migrating from the south to the north to Siberia, and he said he hadn't heard a single crane since being back in Kabul. This was 2004. And we have been discussing the impact of war, years of war, almost 30 years of war, on Afghans and how it traumatized them.